Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to upload a lecture number 9. Today I will explain about effect of series and shunt resistance on performance of perovskite solar device on scaffolding. In today's lecture, I will explain the effect of series and shunt resistance on performance of perovskite solar device in scaffolding. In my lecture, I will also try to address some questions that are related to series and shunt resistance and that are important for all the students and researchers, and their answers need to be addressed significantly. So first of all, I would like to explain the importance of series and shunt resistance and about their introduction and what are the origins of series and shunt resistance and what performance parameters series and shunt resistance can affect, and how we can select series resistance and how we can select shunt resistance, what are their nominal values. And in the second session of my today's lecture, I will try to simulate a structure and try to vary the effect of series and shunt resistance. And then in the last session, I would like to add some conclusion and remarks about today's simulation and the results. So first of all, I would like to explain that series and shunt resistance have very deep impact on device performance. They can increase the performance of any particular perovskite device, and they can also decrease the performance of perovskite device, particularly for lab session as well as simulation session as well. And both series and shunt resistance can govern the shapes and slopes of JV characteristic curves. So we can also check the nature of JV characteristic curve with respect to variation of series and shunt resistance. So mostly we have seen that short circuit current is very deeply affected with the variation of series resistance, and their nature and their graphical representation can be increasing or decreasing with respect to variation of series resistance. In my today's lecture, I will try to show you graphical representation, and I will explain what kind of phenomena will occur with the variation of series resistance by increasing or decreasing its values. Next thing, I am going to explain one by one what are the basic origins that can generate series resistance and that can generate shunt resistance. So next is very important, and a student and researcher need to know about the origins of series resistance. So I would like to explain now about the occurrence or a region of series resistance that normally generates during simulation or during fabrication process. So the origin of series resistance is basically associated with electrical resistance with the contacts like FTU glass and gold, but also with the electrical dissipation that is basically occurring in ETL, HTL and active layer. So basically, there are two main origins for generation of series resistance. We can say that the electrical resistance of FTU, or we can say that front metal contact and back metal contact. And also second reason about the origin of series resistance is electrical dissipation that is basically occurring in ETL, electron transport layer, hole transport layer, or other layers of our architecture. So layers, their dissipation, their electrical dissipation, and the front and back metal contact like FTO and gold are the main origins of generation of series resistance. And so we need to be very careful while selection of FTO or front or back metal contact. And similarly, we must be careful about the electrical dissipation that is being occurred in ETL, HTL and other active layers. So these are two mainly regions that are related to series resistance, that related to occurrence of series resistance during the simulation and during the lab session. Second, I'm going to express the origin of shunt resistance. And it has been seen that the main origin of shunt resistance is charge recombination paths. And the second is basically shunt resistance is greatly affected by the device design, especially the edges can very affect the value of shunt resistance. So mainly two reasons behind shunt resistance is what recombination path, and second one is what the device design, what kind of device we are going to design and what kind of edges can affect either increase or decrease the shunt resistance. So I just explained the main origin of series and shunt resistance. Now I'm going to express the third session, that is about what are the effect of series and shunt resistance on performance parameter. So first of all, I would like to express the importance value of series and shunt resistance. It has been seen that the value of shunt resistance need to be higher in order to get the better performance. I will explain and I will justify it with my simulation work as well. Second thing is about that the value of series resistance should be lower in order to get better performance and the better quality of perovskite device as well as better simulation results. So one person need to know that we need to select, we need to optimize such a values that have lower values related to series resistance, that have little bit higher values related to shunt resistances. So I'm going to explain the effect of shunt resistance. If the shunt resistance will be lower, what will happen? And if the series resistance will be higher, what will happen against the performance of our perovskite device during the simulation? When we talk about the effect of shunt resistance, I just explained that the shunt resistance value must be higher. If its value will be lower during the simulation, what will happen? The lower value of shunt resistance can result in photovoltage losses, and also it can affect the photo generated currents. So both photo generated currents and photo voltages can be greatly affected if the value of shunt resistance will be lower. So we need to get some values that are a little bit higher in case of shunt resistance in order to get better photo generated voltages and better photo current generations. And now I'm going to talk about the effect of series resistance. I just explained that the series resistance should be lower. In what case, and in that case, if the series resistance will be higher, what will happen? If the resistance, series resistance will be higher, fill factor and JC current value, short circuit current value will be greatly affected. Higher the value of series resistance, poor will be the fill factor, and same phenomena can be seen in case of short circuit current value. Now, now we need to optimize in what case we need to get a lower value in case of series resistance in order to get better performance and efficiency. And we need to get higher values of shunt resistance that can provide us better performance and efficiency as well. Now I am going to share with my screen with all of you so that I can justify all the theory, all the related information that just I have explained, and then I can show you how series resistance and shunt resistance can significantly increase or decrease the performance of perovskite device simulation scale 1D. So first of all, I am going to share screen with all of you so that I can start my justification with my simulation results. Okay, over here is the first interfacing layer for my scale 1D. And I have just clicked on performance analysis, IV characteristic curve, quantum efficiency, and just set value 1.5 and then clicked VOC stop value. And initially I am going to set my series and shunt resistance values off state. And because I am going to add some certain range of series and shunt resistance, and then I can explain their effect. And definitely my results will be according to my theoretical explanation that I have just explained, that the lower series resistance will definitely can improve the performance of device, and definitely the higher shunt resistance value can increase the power conversion efficiency VOC and the fill factor as well. So for that case, as I'm going to use a variation of values, like I'm going to change my resistance value from 10 ohm to 100 ohm, and I'm going to use shunt resistance from 500 to 5000 ohm. So I need to use batch setup and record setup in order to compute some tentative graphical representation. And batch setup and record setup is very important. If we try to change the variation of any particular quantity, like you can see that series resistance and shunt resistance, and it can provide us a very smooth graphical representation. So first of all, I need to explain what kind of structure that I am going to simulate. I am going to explain about the effect of series and shunt resistance. This is the typical structure that is going to be simulated once again. But in today's video lecture, I'm going to explain the effect of series and shunt resistance. So over here is the structure that is basically a spiroptamid HDL, perovskite, methyl ammonium, tin tribromide, titanium dioxide, ETL and FQ glass. I have already expressed that the main reasons of occurrence of series resistance is what FQ glass and the back metal contact. And similarly, I have just explained that the electrical dissipation that is being occurring in ETL and HDL and other active layers. But when we talk about shunt resistance, we have seen that, and I have already explained that the origin and the occurrence of shunt resistance is due to recombination paths and the device design, and especially the edges. Edges can definitely affect either increase or decrease the value of the shunt resistance. Okay, now I am going towards my setup because I am more interested in order to compute the effect of series resistance and shunt resistance from certain value to certain value, so that I can get some better results. And this video is also helpful for those persons who don't know about how to use the batch setup and how to use a record setup and what kind of graphical representation. So this lecture is very helpful in two point of view. First one is related to effect of the series and shunt resistance, and second one is related to the usage and utilization of batch setup and record setup. So I am going to click over batch setup. Okay. Whenever we will click on batch setup, it will appear like same window. And now I need to add my values of series resistance from some particular range to particular range, starting to ending range, so that I can get some tentative graphical representation. I need to click over add. Okay. And then I need to select over here series resistance, that is RS ohm dot centimeter square. And then I need to click custom list so that I can put my random values. I need to click on set. Okay, you can see that there is a window appearing over here, and I need to put my values for series resistance over here. Like, I'm going to start my computation from 10 to 100. So I'm going to put 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100. So I am going to check the effect of lower series resistance with respect to higher series resistance. That's why I just vary the range from 10 ohm to 100 ohm. And definitely, I just explained that on the lower values of series resistance, we will have better performance. On higher values of series resistance, we will have a poor degradation of my performance and the simulation results as well. So I need to click update and OK. Next, I need to click OK. I have just selected my values of series resistance. Okay. Now I need to go to once again back to my first interface, because I'm going to set my record setup. I need to click on record setup so that I can get some tentative graphical representations. Okay. Now I am more interested in IV characteristic curve, because I have just explained that the values of series and shunt resistance can greatly affect the IV characteristic curve and their slopes as well. So I'm more interested in IV characteristic curve. And next, what I need to select what kind of performance parameter I need to find. So I'm clicking all the parameters like efficiency, JC, VOC, fill factor, and other parameters. And then I need to click insert above. But in last and second last parameter, I'm not interested. So therefore, I'm going to remove that items from my graphical representation. So I need to click OK. So I just completed my batch setup and record setup related to check the effect of series resistance from a range of 10 ohm to 100 ohm. Now I'm going to start my simulation so that I can conclude that how higher series resistance and lower resistance can affect the performance parameter of my perovskite device in scattering. So I need to click on calculate record. Okay, we need to wait while simulation is being carried out because I have already selected a wide range of series resistance from 10 to 100 ohm and it will take some time. And then I can conclude that what kind of effect lower series resistance and higher series resistance have on performance parameter and which performance parameters are being affected badly with the variation of lower series resistance and higher series resistance. And then there will be a conclusion related to selection of series resistance. And after that, I will try to once again put a batch setup and record setup for variation of shunt resistance from certain range to certain range. And then I will try to explain their effect on performance parameters, how the shunt resistance, lower shunt resistance and higher shunt resistance will affect our performance parameters. So my simulation just completed related to analysis of effect of series resistance, lower series resistance and higher series resistance on my performance of perovskite device. So I need to click on record. Okay, there is first graphical representation over here. It can be clearly seen that with lower series resistance, my efficiency was higher. As the series resistance was increasing, you can see over here, it is what it is 10 ohm, it is what it is 20, 60, 80, and over here 100. And on lower value of series resistance, I have higher values of power efficiency. So one thing I need to conclude over here, what if we have lower series resistance, we will have better power conversion efficiency. And if we will have higher series resistance, as long as the series resistance will tend to increase, the power conversion efficiency will be degraded. And it can be seen over here on 100. On 100 ohm, we have just power conversion efficiency of 2%. And we have seen that there is a big degradation related to power conversion efficiency with variation of series resistance. And now I am going to check another parameter that is about the fill factor. Okay. Once again, it can be seen over here, the value of the fill factor tend to decrease sharply with the variation of 10 ohm to 40 ohm. So it can also be concluded that with the increment of series resistance, the fill factor value tend to exponentially decreases. So once again, we have seen that degradation can be seen in power conversion efficiency with increment of series resistance, and degradation can be seen in case of fill factor as well. Now I'm going to check the effect of variation of series resistance with respect to short circuit current value. Okay, you can see over here, this curve actually clearly explains that when we have lower series resistance, we have higher short circuit current value. As long as the series resistance was increasing, we have exponentially decreasing curve. And on the value of 100 ohm, we can see that we have GSE load 8.5, and on lower value of series resistance, we have higher short circuit current value. So we can see that if the series resistance will be higher, it will affect what? It will affect power conversion efficiency. It will affect what fill factor. It will affect what short circuit current value. I have already explained about the origin and the reasons why actually variation of series resistance can degrade our short circuit current value, fill factor, and power conversion efficiency. Now I'm going to check the effect of VOC. Okay, you can see over here variation of VOC. When we have low resistance, the VOC was about 8.64, and with the variation of series resistance from lower to higher, we can see that there is not too much variation with respect to variation of series resistance. So it can be concluded that the more performance parameter can be affected with the variation of series resistance, that are fill factor, that are basically power conversion efficiency, and that are what short circuit current value. Now I'm going towards the last session of my today's simulation work and today's lecture, that is about the effect of shunt resistors. For that purpose, I need to once again put a record setup and put a bias setup related to certain range of shunt resistance. And I have already explained that we need to select higher values of shunt resistance. Why we need to select, I have explained the reason. So I'm going once again back to my initial simulation. I need to click, first of all, clear simulation, because my garbage value, my previous results must be eliminated. Okay. Now I need to select once again bias setup. Okay. Now I'm going to set my values related to shunt resistance. And so I need to remove this added values of series resistance by clicking remove. And now once again, I need to click on add. And then I need to select my shunt resistance that is located on the bottom of this tab. I need to set the values of shunt resistance by replacing previous data. Now I'm going to change the value of the shunt resistance from 500 to some certain range, 1000, 1500, 2000, 25, 300, 3000, and 3500. I think this range is good enough to get some comparison, to get some good analysis. One person can choose some other certain range as well, from 100 to 1000 like that. And some person can also select a range of other parameters related to shunt resistance. But remember that we will see that higher values of shunt resistance will be very beneficial in order to get better performance of our parameters. So I need to click on what? Update. Okay. I just added to my values of shunt resistance in bias setup. Now I need to go once again back, and then I need to click on record setup. Okay. I'm once again interested in the same values and same simulation results, because I'm trying to check the effect of shunt resistance on VOC, JC, fill factor, eta, etc. So I don't need to vary the values, and I don't need to put some other additional values. So I'm going to just click OK. Now I'm going to start my once again computation related to effect of shunt resistance. I need to click on record, calculate record. Okay. We need to wait while simulation is being carried out, because I have used a range of shunt resistance from 500 to 3500. So it will take some time. And during this simulation, I would once again recall some important things, that we will see that by having higher shunt resistance value, we will have better performance related to parameters like power conversion efficiency, VOC, and fill factor. Three important parameters will be greatly affected with the variation of higher shunt resistance. and almost my simulation is completed. Now I need to go once again to my record. Okay. It can be seen that from first graphical representation clearly that what happens when we have shunt resistance lower, like you can see over here, it is 500, 1000, 15, and so on. As long as the shunt resistance is basically increasing, what happens? My power conversion efficiency is exponentially increasing. It means what? I just explained that higher values of shunt resistance can be very helpful in improving the power conversion efficiency of my device. And reason why is happening, I have already expressed during the initial session of my today's video. Now I am going to check the effect of higher shunt resistance on fill factor and other parameters. Okay, I'm going to click on VOC. So it can be seen that about the VOC, there is not so much variation, but still we can see there is variation. Like we can see on lower shunt resistance, the value of VOC was 8.61. And with the increment of shunt resistance, now the value of VOC is about 8.632. And now next thing, I'm going to check the effect of higher shunt resistance on my fill factor. Okay, it can be seen that once again, we have increasing exponential curve that clearly represent that on lower value of shunt resistance, we have a lower fill factor, about 79%. And as long as we are going to increase this shunt resistance value, we have seen that from the graphical representation, we have fill factor about 83%. So with the increment of shunt resistance, we have seen that power conversion efficiency was increasing, VOC was increasing, fill factor was increasing. And now I'm going to check the effect on short circuit current value. And it is very important thing, short circuit current value is not changeable and it remains the same with effect of higher values of shunt resistance and the lower values of shunt resistance. So, three performance parameters are greatly improved with the variation of higher shunt resistances like power conversion efficiency, VOC, and fill factor. But short circuit current value, you can see that it is almost a straight line. When we talk about the series resistance, we have seen that three parameters are badly affected with the higher values of series resistance. What affected? Short circuit current value, fill factor, and power conversion efficiency. So it was about today's simulation. Now I'm going to conclude my all the today's lecture and the simulation and the basic theory behind for today's video tutorial and lecture. While we are going to select some tentative simulation, we are going to perform some tentative simulation related to perovskite solar cell scavenger. 1% need to carefully select the values of series resistance and shunt resistance. In what case, your values of series resistance must be lower. Like in my case, I strongly recommend you that you can see that in 10 ohm, we have better results. When we talk about shunt resistance, the values of shunt resistance must be higher. Both series and shunt resistance actually move in parallel with each other. One must be lower and second must be higher. And if we will try to have such criteria like lower series resistance and higher shunt resistance, definitely the performance of power perovskite device and simulation results will be greatly affected and improved. I hope this session is very important for those persons, for those students, for those researchers who are trying to check the effect of series and shunt resistance on simulation of perovskite solar cells in scavenger. And if you have some questions, I strongly recommend you can comment on this video session. I will try my level best to explain each and every question. Once again, thank you for all of you for listening to me, supporting me. Take care, stay blessed.